What's up, truth seekers? This is your boy, Black Socrates from Mental Dialogue, where all I ask is that you think. And I wanted to give y'all my 3 cents on the Not One Dime protest in reference to boycotting businesses during the holidays. We saw some success during the Black Friday protest. You're not seeing it necessarily on national news, but black spending was down on Black Friday, and in the African American community, we know a lot that the Not One Dime protests, where we're not spending money in businesses trying to hurt America where it hurts the worst, in the pocket. And so that was a good focus. Now, I will say, for the month of November, due to lowering gas prices, the outlook month of November was actually very positive for the country from an economic standpoint. And so, you know, keep in mind that 11.9% of this country's population, it, you know, like I said, we can definitely be effective with boycotts. But I would But I would like for us to focus it even more. See, I'm very happy to see, for example, I don't know if anybody, if you go to facebook.com/mentaldialogue, go like our page, and there's a beautiful picture of the protest that was done in New York City in reference to police brutality. I want to bring these two hand in hand, and keep in mind that I'm very excited at what I'm seeing with the young people today. They are actually basically galvanized due to this situation to bring light to an ongoing situation that unfortunately our generation has let go to the wayside and just not done anything about it. And these young people are saying they're tired, and it's not just in the African-American community. They're bringing together all cultures to bring a light to this issue and say we're not settling for this. Well, the way I want to connect that with the Not One Dime is to keep in mind we have to have the end game in mind. And so my concern is when I see these protests, we were disrupting public things daily, which I like I said, this is absolutely important, and saying, look, America, wake up, realize this is happening to us. So let's continue that, but let's have the end game in mind. And what I mean by that is effectively ensuring that we can set ourselves up to truly affect policy versus having to beg for policy. And I say that because, unfortunately, to a certain extent, our protest in the past, due to not being allowed within the system, was necessary to have the system take notice. Well, now some things have changed to where maybe we could get in the system, but I don't know if that we've effectively had the right mindset to get within the system. And ultimately, what have we failed to do in the African-American community from the past, with the civil rights movement, with political movements? We've had these movements, but as my friend Mark Ranger always says, we've never had an economic movement. And I hope that the situations that we are experiencing, and if we don't want to necessarily go begging for the system to change, we can effectively change it by learning to do what other cultures do, which is they subconsciously spin within their own culture first. And that's why you see enclaves of different cultures in big cities, for example, whether it be Asian communities, Hispanic communities, and I'm talking about economic enclaves, where you see that they have businesses surrounding them based on that they live there, they eat there, they spend there. And you know, like I said, they're not the only cultures. There's a lot of cultures doing it, but we typically don't see it any longer in the African American community. Now, we know historically that there were times we had black business enclaves, and unfortunately in the past white America has went into those enclaves and destroyed them quite often. And when we actually integrated, unfortunately, a lot of us ran to take our money outside of our community when we no longer had to because of segregation. But that's another argument, you know, for another day. But I want to, once again, address the Not One Dime and how I think we can make it even more effective. See, and, you know, right now, for example, once again, go on the Facebook page. I put the trailer up for Selma, which is the movie that should be coming out later next year. And we know that that's about the bus boycott in Alabama during the civil rights movement that was effective. Well, that boycott took 380 something days, and it was focused on one industry. So I am a little concerned with not one dime, in the sense of saying spend less in the, you know, during the holidays or whatever the case may be. But I know that a lot of the things that you may have used to spending to, or even you're spending less on, maybe things that you need to a certain extent. I know the bigger idea is not to overconsume on gifts and things like that, or, you know, taking advantage of the Black Friday holiday, which we said we already saw was relatively effective. But we could be more effective if we realize that to make a conscious effort to spend our money with ourselves is actually the most effective way to. It's like it's the flip side of boycotting. When in a sense, we're in an era where we're bringing cultures together, and you can say boycott, but if it's not focused in the industry, I'm very concerned. If it took, for example, 380 something days when they were in December, they were focused on one industry. If we're not focused on a specific industry that can bring change, because we're trying to bring change specifically in the police state. Well, imagine if we were now getting the concept of ownership and spending money with ourselves and building businesses within our own community. Well, as owners of these shops and these businesses within our own community, then we would have to create a community policing, because we would need the police to, you know, police our property as well. But right now, without any economic footprint in our own communities, then it's basically the police coming to protect the people who don't live in that community's property, because we've already seen that they make property more important than lives. That's our issue right now. Well, imagine that if we were learning to subconsciously spend our money like with ourselves, like other cultures do, and we were putting up businesses around us of our own, then we would effectively, and also, what is that going to make us do? Go out and vote and put people who understand and protect things that are ours. I mean, it's like, you know, living in an apartment versus living in a home that you own. You may not be as careful, or you may see apartment complexes, people are littering all the time, but you don't litter around your own home when you own something. And so, my focus, in a sense, like I said, this is not to knock one down, because I'm, once again, I'm loving the fact that our young people are galvanized to actually be activists versus the slacktivists that our generation or has been, or we've always assumed them to be. They're proving to us to be something different, and they're not okay with our old tried and old methods that have only brought this situation about. They want to see change. And so the way that I think we could guide them now is to say, okay, and everybody, if we're saying not one dime, how about this? Make a conscious effort, seek out businesses during this time that you can support. And when you get in the habit and teach people that, you should see. I mean, on the internet, you can find all kind of companies. There's also the Around the Way app that I advocate. It's an app that specifically highlights Black businesses that are close to you. Or if you know of new businesses open, or that Black businesses that are opening, please go upload them to the app. And we should all, and not one dime now, if we're going to do that, let's seek out and upload the Around the Way app with all kind of business. Andre Hatchett, Buy Black NYC, is taking the Black Business Challenge all year long, where he goes out daily, literally, and finds Black businesses and shoot videos. So I want to see America, Black America, start doing that. Let's actually flip this not one dime, like I said, keep it going, but actually make it more effective and get the end game in mind. If we find ourselves now having all these Black businesses that we didn't go to in the past, and now we're going to, because we seek it out during this time where you are effectively boycotting these other businesses that you no longer need. And when we teach our young people and the next generation to leave legacies and go in a capitalistic society, get their hands on some money and own things in their neighborhood, and those neighborhoods become ours again. I'm not talking about exclusive spend black only. I think that is impossible in America. I'm just talking about spending with your own first, seeking out, find people who look like yourselves. I'm sincere. I spend extra money, even if it costs a little more, to spend with somebody who's doing good business. Get the assumption out of your head that we don't do good business, but that's what I would love to see people now. During this time when we're galvanized, let's also make a conscious effort. A conscious effort to spend with people who look like you. Every other culture does it, but because we have been programmed to no longer do it, we have to speak about it. Other cultures do it naturally. It is up to us. Buy black. It's revolutionary. My name is Black Socrates, and I've given you a piece of my mind, just my 3 cents. All I ask is that you think.